Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is Corey Heights.
Some battles. I'm not sure if they got us. If they did, maybe.
So you will get better as a player during that year.
So it was kind of exciting. Like, oh yeah, somebody wants me.
One of the last few questions here. You've had a couple guys that, you know, have been in the NBA or in, you know, overseas or McDonald's All-American game recently. Tell me what made those guys professionals and in the top of their game. What separated them from maybe the other players you've coached? And you can give examples of the names too. So
well, what
made, you're talking about.
Two things made them. Two things. Well, three things. First and foremost, they came from outstanding families who let us coach their kid. And that's the one thing I want to pass on to families, parents. Let the coach your kid, please. All right. The second thing is their work ethics. You know, high school kids nowadays have better work ethics, I think, than I did when I grew up. And people might look at me weird because they have more options, but they really don't have more options. And here's why. Okay. I know they got the computer stuff going on and the video games. Trust me, I got a 10th grader who's got the whole mic set up and everything. It's like a studio in his room. But they also have more access than we had. I didn't have a rec center to go to. I had to go outside and play. These guys can go to like a rec center. There's a gym, air conditioned. They can go in and work out. We didn't have the fitness center weight room availability. Just think about it. When I grew up, Gold's Gym was just getting going. I remember we had sand weights in my basement. A lot of people didn't have that. You know, we ordered from the Sears catalog. So, you know, and the third thing is, I come from an Italian household, Federal Hill, Providence, Rhode Island, Sicilian. You think my mother talked about nutrition with me? No way. These kids grow up. Oh, that's a carb. That's a protein. I think I'm going to try being vegan, you know, and the kid's 10 years old. Like, we didn't have any of that stuff. So even though they have more distractions than we had, they still have better opportunities than we had. So that whole gang of kids, their work ethic was outstanding before they got to St. Andrews, and then it doubled when they got here, you know. And then the other thing is, you know, they got it. They were professional and they behaved. We don't have star roles. So Michael Carter Williams, you know, was as important as my manager who climbed up on a ladder one day and changed three bulbs on our scoreboard, which I couldn't do, you know? And that manager now is running four restaurants and like killing it. Matter of fact, he was down in Orlando a couple weeks ago hanging out with Michael, you know? So like everyone's the same here. You know, our announcer is called the voice of the Saints. We had a kid for 6 years. He was in our middle school and he did it. And we put a banner on the wall for him. So, you know, we retired his mic along with numbers and jerseys. It's that important to us. So I think those three things, the family, the work ethic, and the lack of star rules, you know, which leads to good character and good behavior with kids. I think that's why they are where they are. And they right. Just, you could see the development. Bonzi Colson, 14 years old. Hey, coach, he's going to play in the NBA in 8 years. Yeah, right. Yeah, right. There's no way that 14-year-old kid is going to play in the NBA. But he got in with Michael Carter Williams and Cedric Kwakumentsa. Those guys were here when he was here. And he learned how to work. Unbelievable family, you know, and we held him accountable. You know, Sports Illustrated did a story his senior year at Notre Dame. It was all three pages in Sports Illustrated, pictures from Greece. He was Sonny in Greece, the musical. He missed the entire preseason his senior year. Matter of fact, my whole team did, because all 12 of them were in the musical. And that's what I want. I want whole kids. I want to be able to have a conversation. I don't want it to be all basketball. Right. And to see those guys at that level, you know, Demetrius Nichols was our first NBA guy. And Demetrius, and I publicly, I can share his story. Demetrius had a stuttering and stammering issue and was a third grade reader when he came to St. Andrews. We almost did not take him. That kid, when he left here, was a college level kid in 4 years. And I have tears in my eyes watching him. He's got his podcast. He's on ESPN Plus. You know, he did the, what game did he do the other night? I think he did Canisius and Sienna the other night. He's just, here's a kid who had stuttering and stammering issues, right? And now he has a degree from Syracuse in speech communications, and he's killing it in the broadcast world. You talk about a story. So you know, and he played in the NBA, played overseas, total of 17 years professionally. So, I mean, I think those three things we do really well, and we can get certain guys. We've had four NBA guys. You know, we've had four NBA guys. I'd say five, but one kid didn't work out here. He was here for a year, didn't buy in, and he had to leave. But he also played in the NBA. So not bad for a small school of 200 kids in Barrington, Rhode Island.